Huai He River is one of the seven greatest rivers in China. It spans across Henan, Hubei, Anhui, Jiangsu, and Shandong provinces, and is one of four most famous rivers in China, together with Yangtze River, Yellow River, and Jishui River. It has nurtured a great number of hardworking and rustic Huai He people. Tongbai Shadow Puppetry, a Chinese folk opera art spread in the area around Huai He River, is also the oldest shadow puppetry in China. Before every show, there is a worship ceremony. At this time, the shadow puppetry artist becomes the messenger between people and God. A world of stories are told with 1 month and 100,000 of soldiers are played in two hands. Today, a traditional story is on show, offered an official post in a restaurant, which is an old story of a scholar getting rewarded and benefiting his wife and children. Tongbai shadow puppetry arose in the late Northern Song Dynasty more than 1,000 years ago. Soldiers from Jin Kingdom occupied the Northern Song Dynasty's capital, Kaifeng. Some of the artists hid into the mountains of Tongbai to escape the bitterness of war. This relatively safe environment allows shadow art to be preserved, forming today's Tongbai shadow puppetry. The ancient wooden frame, the snow white curtain, and the shadow puppetry character of different shapes accompanying the shadow puppetry artist's coarse voices made great successes in ancient and present times. By today, this kind of scenes is hard to see. Once, there were hundreds of shadow troops in Tongbai County. Now only 4 troops survive. The shadow puppetry artist Peng's family live near the Huai He River bank. When it's sunny, Peng will sit in the courtyard with his father and rehearse the shadow play. Most of the shadow plays are adapted from historical stories and passed down by the ancestors through oral means. Father Peng Guangqi sang a lifetime of shadow play. Although he did not want his son to continue to sing shadow play, he still passed his only cup to Peng Dayi. Peng Dayi grew up in the rhythms of shadow puppetry. He can sing, play, and carve. He's a real talent in shadow puppetry. Although he did not learn much in school, he can barely read. Peng Dayi can sing plays for a week without repeat. Tongbai Mountain bred the Huai He River and also gave the ancient shadow play a refuge. Today's people are trying to transcend the barriers of nature and psychology to protect the spiritual homeland left by their ancestors. For thousands of years, the meditative ancestors, in the hard work of cultivation, constantly discovered the secrets of plant growth. Crops from north and south gathered in the Huai He River basin, providing people with a wide variety of food. It is the expression of Huai He people's wisdom to exert imagination on changing the forms of food. A bowl of hot beef vermicelli is people's favorite snack here. fine smooth vermicelli in a boiled thick beef bone soup, ups and downs with the intense stimulations of chili oil, becomes the unchanged breakfast for many people in many years. In October, it turns cool. Slender vermicelli hangs in the courtyard and all over village. This is the most common scenery in winter in Dako Town, Si County, Huaibei Plain. Making vermicelli is a skill that every family in Huaibei masters. Early in the morning, the whole family of Chen Jingran is busy in their own vermicelli workshop. He grew up learning to make vermicelli from his father by today. He has had nearly 40 years of experience in making vermicelli. A small vermicelli workshop sustains the whole family's livelihood. Chen family's vermicelli is made from sweet potatoes. Despite the rough appearance of its food, its wide adaptability and endurance in dry and barren oil make its production reach nearly 3,000 kilograms per mu, feeding the largest number of population with same size of land. So it has become one of the most widely planted crops in the Huai He River basin. In the hard times, in order to have enough food, people in Huai He rural areas made the sweet potatoes the most common main food during a day. Under old Chen's command, the whole family are working together. This is related to a person's skill. People with good skill can often make long, thick, and even vermicelli. The process of pasting is most important part, filled with rhythm and tempo. Old Chen decided to do it himself. Because the temperature has not yet reached below zero, the new-made vermicelli has to be put into the cold storage. After a whole day of freezing, the drying must be done in the windy days. In one mu of drying field, the sweet potato stretches, facing the autumn wind, turn ductile and smooth, and become the most plaintest of the Huai He family. In fact, there is no distinction in value among foods, whether it is sea cucumber, abalone, or potato vermicelli. What makes us feel good is actually the taste of food and the memory of them between our taste buds. Whether it's an old rhythm or a mellow taste, the Huai He River combines the south and north, carries a long history, and silently nourishes the lives along it. Persist with strength and march forward with persistence. This is the homeland we have been keeping for generations, and also the homeland of our spirit.